Alrighty, welcome to another Legacy Cube, you know, Channel Fireball. What are you going to take here? Well, the obvious first pick's Moldrifter. Moldrifter's very good. Better than Force of Will in terms of blue cards. There's Kozilek, but I actually don't love Kozilek Butcher of Truth compared to, say, New Ulamog. Because just drawing four, as much as I am loath to admit it, is not as good as exiling two things. So sometimes you can cast Kozilek and still be dead. There's also Young Pyromancer. I'm kind of tempted just to take Young Pyromancer and see where that takes me. I just want to draft either a Delver deck or a Mono Red Burn deck. Both those sound kind of interesting, and I want to see if such a thing is possible. Well, next card I see is Meteor Blast, which red, deal 4. Or red, 4 mana, deal 4. 5 mana, deal 4 to 2 things. Okay, I'm not actually super impressed by that. But in terms of blue, I mean, there's Seagate, Oracle, or Dissolve. Neither of those really are that exciting. Manic Vandal's not as good in Legacy Cube as it would be in Vintage Cube. There's just less artifacts. Swirling Outburst, which does work well with Pyromancer. Hall of Triumph, which also, I guess, technically works well with Pyromancer, but I don't really want to take Hall of Triumph here. Could just take Meteor Blast. Actually, I'm going to take the Hordling Outburst. Let's draft some red cards. Ooh, or we could just take Ponder. Ponder's very good. Ponder Pyromancer. There wasn't a blue card to take last pick. Anyway, there's also Incinerate in Pia, in Kiran, Nalar, and Taiga. I want to draft a Delver deck. So let's see if we can draft red-blue Delver. Can we set up a Bonfire of the Damned? Probably not. We could take Careful Study, though. That also seems a little sketchy. Maybe Bonfire is actually the pick. Pick up a Brainstorm. There's also Teferi, Lightning Helix. I don't like those as much. Could also still be Mono Red. The thing about Mono Red is that even if I do end up Mono Red, losing out on the Ponder is not a huge deal because presumably I'll wheel something for the Mono Red deck. If you end up not wheeling anything for Mono Red, then decent chance you shouldn't have been Mono Red anyway. That deck usually can't support two players very well. Alright. I like taking Fire Ice here. It's good if you're Delver, it's good if you're Mono Red. Better than Gitaxian Probe, I believe, or Tropical Island, or Spike Shot Elder. Alright. Fire Ice, I like it. So, this deck. Basically, if you end up being like, when I keep saying Delver, I mean like a red-blue tempo deck, or if I end up Mono Red, it's just an aggressive burn deck. There's Goblin Bombardment, which actually works with both those things, but I might just take Ral Zarek. Don't really like Crater's Claws all that much, it's basically just Fireball. This is to bolster the Black Sacrifice theme, presumably. But Ral seems better, and then if you wheel Bombardment, cool. Alright, probably just gonna take Misty Rainforest here. Again, Purphoros, Eldrazi Monument. There is a tokens theme going on here, and Threads is an interesting card, but I think Misty is important if I want to try to cast two colors worth of spells. Ooh, I could take Kiki. I'll take Kiki, because also I'm set up to be a red-blue deck, and getting a late Kiki Jiki is nice, so that means no one else is really fighting me for this, plus Active Aggression and Serendipity Feed are both so medium. Alright, this is a good setup, because I also could easily transition into, like, Deceiver XR Kiki deck, which fits nicely in the Pyromancer plan too. Could just have both those plans going. Alright, well, here I think I'm just going to take Skullcrack. I could just be a burn deck. I've got all these options, plus I don't really want any of these other cards, so seems like an easy pick. Probably just take Meteor Blast now. Still just don't think Manic Vandal is very good in this cube, and Meteor Blast is in fact a relevant burn spell. And here's an Incinerate. Alright, I'm going to take Incinerate over Taiga. I don't see an indication that I'll be splashing green, and I guess, well, taking Taiga does make Misty Rainforest red-blue fetch. That's probably worth more than a burn spell. It's just so much better to have good mana. You end up having plenty of spells. I'll take Helix. Maybe I'll splash it. Who knows? But, yeah. Ooh, Ingataxian Probe Wield. All right. Definitely better than Spike Shot. I think a lot of the kind of cards I'm looking for, and Bombardment Wield too, that's kind of nice too. I would need more than Pyromancer plus Hordling Outburst to play Bombardment, but it is a good place to go if I know that these things are open. So this pack I think was quite good for me. Getting a late Kijiki is good. Pyromancer's looking great in this deck. I mean, Ponder and Probe, Fire Ice already make it good. And then if I do want to either go Mono Red, I have the options to do that. The cards are there. The deck is open. If I pick up an early Exarch or Pestermite, I could be good red-blue. And there's also a token theme going on here. So, ooh, Purphoros, see? That's another token card. So, let's see. Let's put the, red-blue control cards here. The, really heavy token theme cards there, and then the burn cards there with a couple mana fixings here. Alright, where are we at? Probably at Chain Lightning. Chain Lightning does well in all these themes, and I'm assuming I'm going to wheel Hellrider. Hellrider also very good with tokens and good in the mono-red deck. Less good in the red-blue deck. Spell Pair is very good in the red-blue deck, not good in any other deck. Alright, I'll take Chain Lightning here, because I think that's just a solid good red card. Put Ralzeric over here, because Fire Ice also can just be a straight red card if I need it to be. Well, now I've got to make a decision. There's Bloodstained Mire, Electrolyze, Stagger Shock, and Frenzied Goblin. Can rule out the Frenzied Goblin right away. Bloodstained Mire is not too bad if I pick up a black-blue duel or something, like, say, that Watery Grave. That can also be a blue-red land. There's also Talrand. Huh. Is Electrolyze a better card than Talrand for this deck? Talrand might actually be... Maybe I want to try drafting red-blue tokens. All right, I'm going to take the Talrand. And... see what I can do with all this. Probably take out Skullcrack and Meteor Swarm. Oh, none of these cards really help me in any way. Yeah, I guess I'm just back to just taking Gorehouse Chainwalker in case I end up mono red. Don't really like the sound of that, but don't know that I can do better. I don't want Legacy's Lore, I don't want Temple of Mystery. I guess if I take Temple of Mystery, I've got a good green splash going. Yeah, Gorehouse will wheel, and it's just so relevant. This is not a Guild of Lotus deck. I love Guild of Lotus, but this is not a Guild of Lotus deck. Just want some cheap spells. That's all I'm looking for. Alright, probably taking Glenelendra Archmage here. I do like Inferno Titan in general, but Archmage I found to be truly excellent. Also good with Purphoros. And I don't love Roast, whereas Archmage just gets everyone so good. Probably going to take Imperial Recruiter here, because that gives me a couple things. One, it gives me an out to being the Kiki combo still, which I still think is good. Because you can Recruiter for Kiki, play Kiki, copy Recruiter, Recruiter for Pestermite. It also can just get like Glenelendra, Talrand, Young Pyromancer. These are all just good cards. So I think it's better than Brimstone Volley, Stormkirk, Noble, Repeal, or Waterfront Bouncer. So I'm in. Alright, probably in for Rabble Master too. That seems like another good token card. Yeah, better than Plateau or Badlands. Those don't do anything particularly for me either. Don't want Irish Shaman. This is just not a bad Abbot of Carol keep. There's also Sacred Foundry. That doesn't do much. There's Goblin Bushwhacker, which technically does do stuff with tokens. I think I'm just going to take the Looter, though. Looter's just a good card. It helps you set up all these different synergies. I think that's a little bit more important. Basically, Bushwhacker is good when everything's going well for your deck. Looter's good at making sure things go well for your deck. Is this a Monastery Swiss Spear deck? Might just be taking Arc Trail here, just because I need spells to trigger this Pyromancer and this Talrand. Though Swiss Spear also works quite well in a deck that's playing a bunch of spells too. I think Swiss Spear is powerful enough that I'll just take it, even though I do like Arc Trail. I just assume I can pick up some burn, whether it's this pack or the next. And Hellrider did Wheel, which I do like as well. So I'm just like an aggressive red-blue tokens deck. I never said those words before. We'll see if they end up making sense. Alright, Stagger Shock fits the bill quite nicely, so I'm going to take Stagger Shock over Tangwire and Frenzied Goblin. One drops, two drops, three drops, four drops. Alright. Yeah, actually, can probably just get in the Skullcrack in here. And Gorehouse Chainwalker did Wheel, though I'm not even clear that I want it yet. Got a lot of playables already, so I definitely can pick and choose where I end up here. Wouldn't have minded maybe ending up with the Spell Pierce in this kind of deck. How many spells do I have? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 that trigger my Pyromancer and Talrand. Alright, I could go for picking up a few more. Ralzeric could easily be cut. Alright, I'll play Roast. Sure thing. And all the cards I want, though I think I just take Brimstone Volley here. Since I want mostly burn spells at this point. And Volcanic Islands. Burn spells and Volcanic Islands. Actually, I don't care about playing as Gravecrawler. If someone manages to somehow cast Divinity of Pride, that seems like it would be bad news for me. Irish Shaman not completely off the table. It's 2-mana, 2-1 Menace, I guess. Ooh. Alright. I'll snap that up. Snapcaster is better than Fork Bolt or Rift Bolt, because one of the two will probably wheel. In fact, I could almost guarantee it. There's the other Ulamog. I don't mind Storm Breath either, but Probe, Ponder, Chain Lightning, Fire Eyes. Yeah, these are all just great with Snapcaster Mage, so Snapcaster it up. Ooh, Ancestral Vision, Dual Caster Mage, Gifts Ungiven. If my mana can support it, Ancestral Vision sounds awesome. I'm just going to take that. I don't want to play with Ancestral Vision. Wheel, Dual Caster Mage, or Banefire. Yeah, actually, there's not even that much competition here. All right, just to make sure we're not actually mono red, I picked up two great blue cards, picks one and two. And probably just taking Lightning Bolt over Master Wave. Zealous Conscript goes infinite with Kiki, but I think this deck just wants Lightning Bolt. Lightning Bolt is just such a good card. And passing up no red-blue duels. I would take Volcanic Island or Steam Vents over basically anything at this point since my spell slots are well filled here. Actually take out Iron Shaman. Ooh, I'll take the Abbot. I think it's going to be better than Stratus Dancer. I don't hate Outpost Siege, especially you can name dragons to go with your tokens. And I do like Pact, but Abbot is just good with all these cheap spells. Probably get Bonfire out of here at this point. This has all the cards I want. It has Delver and Kiln Fiend and Keranos and Magma Jet and Daze. These are all fantastic cards for this deck. Even Avalanche Riders are not terrible. I think I'm going to take Daze. I want to up the amount of disruption I have, and I feel like one of these two will wheel, and they're so equivalent. I wouldn't mind Magma Jet either. Yeah, Daze. Upping the number of the spell count seems really important. I'll probably just take Prophetic Flame Speaker now. Though Devil's Play is surprisingly good. I really want Volcanic Island. Ugh. Yeah, maybe I do take... Yeah, this card maybe just sucks. Alright, I'll take Devil's Play. This is like one of the better fireballs because at least you get to flash it back. I think that's better than the advantages on like Banefire or the other various X spells. They're mostly just X spells, but Devil's Play has a real advantage. Might actually take Purphoros out. I don't know if Purphoros is the direction I want to go. I like Manowar, I like Firebolt, and I like Serum Visions. I think I'm going to take Serum Visions here. Setting up good plays is what this deck wants to do. And yeah, the mana can't be that bad. Taiga and Misty and then a bunch of islands and mountains. I wish it was better, but I've got double blue, double red. Oh, Temple, not going to help me. Mog War Marshal, Sarkhan the Dragon Speaker. Mog War Marshal, is that good enough? It's good with Goblin Bombardment, certainly. But I don't even know if I'm playing Purphoros. It's decent with Hellrider. I'll take the War Marshal. I don't think I'm playing Sarkhan. See, Fork Bolt and Rift Bolt did wheel. Given that I have Fire Ice, I think I'm just going to take Rift Bolt. Yeah. Taking out Mog War Marshal. Taking out Skullcrack. Taking out Roast. Taking out Devil's Play. Kind of want to take out one of these creatures. I could take out Imperial Recruiter. I don't know if I actually want to spend extra time and then put it back in Devil's Play maybe and play 17 lands. Is Devil's Play better than Skullcrack? I don't think so. Plus, actually, I might wheel in that pack with Delver and whatnot. There's a decent chance I wheel one of those cards, so I'll take out the Devil's Play in anticipation of that. Oh, Dual Caster, probably better than Banefire. Though I don't think I'm Dual Castering. It is nice with Ancestral and Rift Bolt, because you can suspend them, then a turn later Dual Caster. I guess it's okay with Probe. It's a cantrip, dude. Yeah, I don't know if that's enough to make me want to play it. Alright, I'll take Zealous Conscripts. It's a good sideboard card, at least. If you could tutor for it with Imperial Recruiter, I'd kind of be tempted to play the Conscripts, Kiki, Recruiter. But instead, I'm just going to play none of them. None of the cards I want are wheeled. I guess I'll take Outpost Siege. Though I think... Oh, never mind. This was the pack. Alright, I'm going to take Delver. I'd rather just have one drops. I'd rather just have a cheaper card, and I think that's going to end up being better. So right now, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 12 cards that flip Delver. I could probably do a little bit better than that, can't I? All right, sort by converted mana cost. You know, Goblin Bombardment, probably not good enough. It's funny, I think Hellrider is the Goblin Bombardment I'm actually looking for. And I think I would rather just have a Skullcrack instead. I actually kind of have a lot of creatures. Maybe a Roast is just going to be better. Since I played against three green decks in my last cube. So if I play Roast, this deck could also just play 16 land. Never mind. Yeah, because I have got Serum Visions, Ponder, Gitaxian Probe. Okay. And Looter. Could also not play Looter. That is a possibility. If I took out Looter, I could put in just another burn spell. Devil's Play? I don't even know if that's good. And how's my mana going to be? Alright, well, let's sort by color. So if I add those two, I'm going to have to play more. So this has 8 blue sources and 9 red sources, actually, even though I'm going to play an extra blue on purpose because I've got 3-4 blue card draw spells. I've got Cerumidian's Ponder, Ancestral, and Looter. I'm not counting Probe here. So 9 blue sources, 7 red. Oh, and it's 9 blue and 8 red. Yeah, actually, though, this mana doesn't seem bad to me. All right, let's try this. I haven't drafted a deck like this before, but this looks really sweet.